Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. This reading for today, this is a daily collective love reading, love message for all signs. Thank you so much for your support. Thank you so much guys for being here. If you would like to further connect with me, please click the bell and click the subscribe button, okay? This is a love reading. This is a love message for all signs. This is an open message for all of you, so I want you to really connect with me. As I shuffle the cards, I want you to think of your romantic situation, okay? Think about your romantic situation. Think about your person. Let's connect with them. And I will be doing you versus them reading, and we will also look into the future of your connection, their feelings, their intentions, and the next move in the future of your connection, okay? And at the end of the reading, I'll go around the table and pull one card, a message for each sign. Daily collective reading. This is a love message, all right? What can I get for all signs? Thank you so much, guys, for your support. What is the love reading, collective reading for all signs? I have already uploaded your collective reading. It has the new moon in Gemini. It is an amazing read. I was able to download a lot of cosmic guidance in there, so please check it out. It is already uploaded. What is the love reading, love message, collective reading? I am channeling June to December. Okay, June to December energy. Now we've got the Hangman. Okay, all right. Okay, so this is a collective reading. Let's start with the first reading. You have the Ten of Swords. I think you're very brokenhearted. The first reading, you're very brokenhearted with this new person. The first reading is definitely applicable to someone who, it could be an ex, but they keep coming back and disappointing you. For some of you, this is a revelation for some of you guys. You know, look at that Seven of Pentacles in here. You have this ex person or someone you dated, and I could feel that they played you. I think you might have found out that this person is with another person now, or they've completely ignored you. Like, this is a reading where you're having your moment. You're probably confronting them because this is the Ten of Swords, you know? Like, this is a reading where it's a bad breakup, or it's a bad way to break up. It's also like a combination of emotional, your rage, your angry, your disappointment, and also you're like giving up on them, okay? And the first reading is definitely, it's also you breaking free, okay? Because Seven of Pentacles in here, you know, you had enough. You keep waiting for this person and keeping this precious golden Ace of Pentacles for them. And all they did is to come back and make you feel, make you believe, okay? This is like, you're going to have your own breakthrough, okay? And I'm doing this love reading, love message. I feel like you're going to have a breakup with your soulmate, or at least you're going to break the bond. Like, you're going to empower yourself to really stop liking this person, stop wanting this person. Like, your heart is turning into stone with this person. Like, how many times have you been disappointed by this person, okay? The Hermit card, this is a full wisdom. The first reading, you're coming to a point where you are embracing a Hermit energy because it's just too much now, okay? You're coming to a point where Ten of Swords, you have moved on, close off the chapter of you and them. They came back again. They disappointed you again, okay? Yeah, the Eight of Pentacles in here. Like, two, okay, they want me to keep the Two of Cups in reverse. You have so many whys. like this is a reading where I was able to move on. I'm good. I'm great. You came back. You made me feel love. You made me feel something that I believe. And they disappear again. Okay? This is like a point of view where I don't want to return. Like you don't want to feel it anymore. You know? Like this is a reading where the Hermit card, your soul does not want you to feel this love and romantic feelings with this person. It's just too much, okay? For some of you, it really broke your heart when you found out that they're with someone or they're back with their ex, okay? For some of you, again, you know, I'm hearing the word again, like this person keeps dividing you. And I'm hearing the word, you're starting to feel strange towards this person in such a way that I think this person has no heart or like heartless. You are really going to put yourself into a full soul-searching hermit card energy where I need to detach because it's too much for my soul to bear another heartbreak from this person. Like, finally, this is a reading where you're setting yourself to a face-to-face, to an awakening that I have to read, I have to declare my own breakthrough. This is too much, this reading, and I'm doing this new moon in Gemini, so you could be breaking up with a soulmate energy bond. Yeah, two of wands. Something tells me as much as you would like this person, you've got to give up the feelings. Okay, it's just too much. It's between your soul and them. Yes, the Hierophant card, the key is recuperating. So for some of you, where does broken, you know that song, where do broken hearts go? Okay, soul searching. So for some of you, because this is a love reading, this is a love message, it's coincide with the new moon. Your new moon is to fall in love with yourself. This reading is to fall back in love with yourself. Okay? I think this is recently. This is heartbreak. Yeah, it's not over. There's more lovers and romantic energy. The world is not going to stop for you. Okay? You will continue to move on. Like, you still like this world card in reverse, it's giving me a vibe that keep moving because there's more for you. In fact, this is a good riddance, okay? Go soul searching, go and power up because I believe the universe just saved you from a major disaster heartbreak, okay? Because this person is not meant for you. Okay, this person is particularly, you know, they have a letter L. They have a letter L, they have a letter P, they have a letter K and a C. Okay, like they already joined forces with another person. This is applicable if you've been ghosted recently, like if you have been, you know, they have love bombed you and they disappear again. They went back to another person. It's like, it's why? Like, this reading is to liberate you. This is to liberate you because you have so many whys. Like, you're questioning why they're so sweet to me and this to me and this to me and now they breadcrumbs me and they disappear. And for some of you, you've recently stalk-ish them or you found out with somebody that they're seeing someone, okay? Something online that you would find out, okay? So this is a soul-searching. Your new moon is to fall in love with yourself, to increase your self-esteem, your self-confidence, because to be honest with you, there's more coming for you, okay? This person's just creating block in your life. So gather your beautiful energy together, soul search, wear your crown, take your power back, and go and put yourself again to a new love adventure, okay? All right, now, the second reading, that's quite heavy. I think this is a new moon revelation. Love, liberate, like this is, you know, the first reading is somehow you know they cheated on you. You know that they ghosted you. You know that this person is doing something meany. Okay? And this new moon is highlighting and illuminating not the romantic side of this person, the darker side of this person. If you know the dark side of them, do you still want them romantically? This is your new moon energy as well, okay? Now, the second reading, you have a Knight of Swords. You have an Eight of Cups. You have the Hierophant card. The second reading, this is specifically connected to an ex, okay? Because this could be a combination of someone you dated with all of your heart and you waited for them. This is quite heavy and also very hopeless romantic. But you did enjoy the connection, you know. I wouldn't blame you. This person is amazing. So amazing in terms of romantic chemistry, but attitude, behavior, very uncertain, very not trustworthy at all. Okay. Now, excuse me. The second reading, this is a Knight of Swords. This is an Eight of Cups. This is specifically applicable to an ex, okay? The Star card. You know what? This ex of yours, in the next 3, 7, 10 days, they will confront you. This ex of yours, they will confront you. You have an ex and you probably disconnected and tried to reconcile, but then it ended up with some very heated argument with the Knight of Swords in here. And this person, they will find themselves connecting with you, and they've kept some of their feelings away from you. Why they did that, why they were angry, why they were inconsistent. I think they've kept it, like, they kept it for so long. Now they're very open, like, they're very ready to let it out. So you have an ex who will contact you, and they're quite sad and a bit upset. I think something is triggering them to contact you, okay? I think they're going through a lot. They're very low. Like, I'm seeing this ex. They're going through a lot. They're very low. And they're going to connect with you to lash out. But them coming towards you or connecting with you, I think there's something like, hi, hello, how are you? And then you might say something about them. And then it will trigger them to tell you that, hey, do you know why I was inconsistent? Do you know why I break up with you? Or do you know why I cheated on you? Because of this, because of that. So you will be shocked because of some revelation that you don't expect this person to lash out. There is a bit of, like, unexpectedly, they will tell you why. They will reveal their darkest and deepest feelings towards you. For them, okay, this person, it's a good thing that they were able to release the darkest and the deepest feeling. Whatever angst they have for you, they're able to release that. But they release it in the wrong timing because it's a situation where you're quite shocked. You're connecting with me. You're saying hi, hello, and then you're angry, you're mad. You will figure it out with a Star card that, okay, now I know the reason, you know, this person is going through a lot. So they're connecting with you, but they have underlying issues with some people, some stuff in their life. And somehow they were able to somehow lash out or impulsively, emotionally release something towards you, okay? You're gonna be shocked with their, like, it's quite exaggerated. It's more of like you ask them something and they lash out and you will figure it out and you will realize, okay, that was not meant for me. That was for them. That was for them to release that, okay? So it's kind of like, I don't know, this person is comfortable to express you their darkest feelings. They have a problem. In fact, they needed a friend. Ten of Swords. They were able to release a lot of unwanted thoughts, unwanted feelings towards you, but it's not fair. they were supposed to say hi or hello to you or check in with you, but out of the blue, they lash out. They're going through a lot. Now, the Hierophant card, oh, the 10, I know. So the thing is, this person, they realize, so what's going to happen is like you'll be shocked with whatever they're going to reveal. Like you will be shocked because, okay, that is the darkest thoughts and feelings towards you. And on top of that, they might reveal what they're going through. I see them probably not entirely ghosting you, but they might be gone for 1 or 2 or 3 days or a week. But this person, they will come back to you in another day, okay? They will come back to you again with full disclosure and apology, very apologetic and very sweet. And somehow that conversation or that argument, a little bit of argument, heated, like it's quite intense. Let's put it this way. It's intense coming from them. It's like you're shocked. Why are they coming at me? I'm not the problem. They have a problem. Like this person needs a hug. Okay. Maybe you can tell that them, like, do you need a hug? Are you okay? Because they're not okay. Now, they will come back to you. They're going to say sorry, Ten of Pentacles and Hierophant card. It feels different. You know, it's a person who was able to say every little demon. Like, this person was able to release all of the demon thoughts, feelings, and, you know, repressed feelings, information that is bothering them. So when this person comes back to you, they're very apologetic and they're seeing you as a lover now, not as a villain. So it's going to be a completely different cycle or dynamic. The way they will talk to you, the way they will, like the way they will approach you, talk to you, it's different. It's like the respect and admiration. It's like meeting you first time again. You know, when a couple fights, the pain and the hurt or whatever, you know, when couple fights, the buildup of anger or disappointment, the buildup of low vibe energy, negative energy, the buildup of negative energy, it comes up. And if you don't spend time to be, you know, to make it stronger again, you know, you would never recover. This one, when they're able to lash out what they feel, all the negativity that they feel towards you, it's gone. So the way this person sees you is different. Like you're no longer the villain in their story. You are their hero, or it's like seeing you again for the first time. So there's love. Okay. So some negative vibe is gone. So it's completely different. Okay. So don't block them. The message is that you might have some intense. It's an ex. Or probably someone you dated on and off and on and off. This one, there's no third party, okay? There's no third party. This is a little bit of a third party, multiple dating in here. Maybe ex-husband, ex-wife. Now, this one, the main message is that don't block them. They'll come around with a big confession, big feelings, big revelation, apologetic. And then it's going to be different from then on. Your dynamic is going to be like something is going to be lifted up. Okay. Now the last reading, this is a new person. Okay. This is a new person. The Knight of Cups, the Magician, the Hangman. So you have a new romantic energy. I think you are channeling this Knight of Cups. They've recently broken up. Okay. The month of June, probably the mid part of June, they're just stepping into the broken, you know, the feeling broken, breakup energy. Now, this person, it's more likely that they will reappear. Maybe you know them already. It could be 2 to 3 degree in your social community. Okay. Right now it could be 4th degree of friend, or work and then colleague. You have a common connection, okay? Now, mid of June, this person is gonna step away from the breakup energy. So the third week of June, you will meet this person. Okay, the Knight of Cups, the Magician card, the Hangman. Well, it's a surprise how you're going to meet this person. But I'm seeing like a musical event. There is also, there's a musical event, there's movies, like it's a nighttime event, a nighttime party, a nighttime gathering. There is, there's a valet parking, there's musical, and I'm also fully dressed, like you're like really dressed up for some of you guys. So you're going to meet this person there. It is a new love, okay? And they have a letter D. Like the event, it has a D and an M. And an I and an A, the event, or that, or the, their name, or the person that's going to invite you. There's a D and an M, an I and an A, yeah, with this new love, okay. Now, the last reading, I'm going to go round the table and pull one card for each sign, okay. So, the first reading is for the air sign. If you are a Gemini, what is your daily love message, love reading? If you are a Gemini, the person that is on your mind right now, they're playing Cupid. They're playing hard to get. And don't play the game. Do not chase them, Gemini, okay? That is for Gemini. If you are a Libra, you're dealing with someone who's probably upset with you. Four of Wands, okay. So if you are a Libra, the love message for you, Four of Wands, the Five of Wands, is that they will probably reply, respond to you at the time of, I think this person that is on your mind, Libra, with the Four of Wands, look at this, the Ten of Wands, they're going through a lot. You will be surprised that this person will message you or reply to you, respond to you, and it's an invitation. And I don't know why I'm seeing their message will come to you in the evening and then you're gonna reply in the morning time. So the person that is on your mind, they're going through with the Ten of Wands. They don't want to start something they meant to end. So if they start texting you, calling you, the next stop is an invitation, okay? Now, if you are an Aquarius, if you are an Aquarius, your daily love message for today, the person that is on your mind is very much attached to a somebody or to a project, and that is their main priority. If you feel like Aquarius, that this person is giving you a hot and cold, because being romantic is not their priority. Their priority is cleaning up something in their life, like problem solving. They're also dealing with lots of family issues in here. But they're not very romantic. That's why they're cold to you, Aquarius. That is the current energies of your person, the person that is on your mind. Now, the second batch of reading is for earth signs, okay? If you are a Capricorn, the person that is on your mind, they will message you, okay? Just chill. This person, they could be upset or angry, but they will reply. They will message you, Capricorn, the person that is on your mind, okay? Taurus, okay? The person that is on your mind miss you. They miss you a lot. They're thinking when to call you and when to see you. So you just relax because they have a plan to visit you or see you, okay? Now, the last reading for the earth signs is for Virgo, okay? The person that is on your mind, oh, they like you. The person that is on your mind, Virgo, they like you, they miss you, they're playing a little bit Cupid, but they will make the move, and their move is bold, regardless of their gender. This is an alpha one. So expect a call or an invitation. They want to accelerate the messaging. They want more. You would know that in their next message or next reply, okay? Now, the third reading is for the water signs. Let's start with Scorpio. Scorpio, what is your card of the day? Love message for today. Ooh. You know this lover miss you and also is hesitating. You have an Emperor Scorpio. They would connect, they would message, but they're probably upset or frustrated with what, with everything that's happening, with what's going on. I think they want to message you or call you or somehow continue you and them. However, there's still a bit of blur in the background. This person has dark thoughts, but not about you. Somebody else, okay? Yeah, Four of Cups. It's like this person, Scorpio, they couldn't help but think of you, but they're still the surrounding, like they're surrounded by problematic people or last minute things that they kind of need to solve. Like this person, they're very strategic, Scorpio, which means that they would like to come back to you when everything is clear. Like their head is full of dark thoughts or something to do with solving problems, but it's not connected to you. Okay, they're the Emperor, so they're managing it. Like it's a person who, I want to solve this problem so I can be with you, Scorpio. Okay, and I'm also hearing the word, they're not making an excuse. This is really their life. Okay, now Cancer, this is the current feelings, current energy of your person. Cancer, this person is very worried about you. They're manifesting that you reply or that you call them or text them. I think this person, Cancer, eventually they will reach out, but they're very worried about you forgetting about them. Okay? I could feel the panic with this person, so they might reach out soon. Pisces, what is the love message for you today? Okay. Well, good news. Oh, so for some of you guys, you have someone from overseas or someone who just completed a cycle who's going to reach out. It could be new love or it could also be someone from the past. So you have two new love energy coming, at least the next 3, 7, 10 days, Pisces. So that's for the water sign. Now, the last reading is for the fire sign, Aries. What is the love message for you today? The person that is on your mind, Aries, is very chill. They're about money. They think of you romantically, but they're into money. I think this person, they've been sick lately. The person that is on your mind, Aries, there's something health or family issues or some personal drama going on that they want to just relax and not be romantic. But they think of you. They care about you. They find you very cute and they find you very patient. Okay? Now, Leo, what is your daily love message? What is the, you know, the current energies of the person you're thinking right now? It's a King of Swords. Wow, it looks like this is an ex. Now, this ex of yours is going to finalize maybe their divorce, some paperwork. But there is a big decision coming from this person, Leo. So watch out because their decision will affect you and them. And I think it's for the best, Leo. Now, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, okay, what is your love message for today? Two cards. Oh, so Sagittarius, the person that is on your mind is the Devil card and the Strength card. They're playing Cupid and playing stubborn. I'll get another one. The Five of Cups, they miss you a lot, but they won't move. And I feel like this person, the ball is in their court. So let them miss you. Whatever torture or feeling I miss you, they're eventually going to break out from that because they kind of need, this is a very stubborn person, Sagittarius, look at that, stubborn, then Devil, they miss you so much, they love you so much, but they don't express it, so they're fighting their own demon, so let them have and experience the Five of Cups, this is their own. It's like the source of their pain, and the source of their pain and drama is coming from them, not you. Because I could feel that you're welcome and open to have them. So let them fight their own demon, their own playing Cupid energy. They will have their own breakthrough, okay? Because they can't fight the feelings anymore right now, especially the new moon. There's so much pressure to this person. Like, they're quite in panic or worried that you've completely forgotten them. So they kind of need to make a move before it's too late, okay? And this is your dailies, guys. Love reading, love message. And I'll see you soon again, guys. You take care and have a great day. And please don't forget to watch the New Moon in Gemini Collective. It's already uploaded. I'll see you soon. You have a great day. Bye bye.